Welcome back, everybody. Last video for tonight. What I've done is I've made the ladders for this caboose. And as you can tell, I have been doing some sanding the roof. I've got this all smoothed out up top. I kept the line for the rivet line up here for this. Smoothed out all this. I kept the rivet lines here and smoothing all this out right now. Kind of get a smooth plate down here at the bottom. This side, same thing. I'm smoothing it. I smoothed out the window so we have this nice area right here for the decal to go into. Then I'm getting all this smoothed out as well before paint. As you can tell, yes, I did get the marker lights on there. I do not have the jewels in it right now, but I'll put those in either before or after paint, because those are going to be painted black. I've still got some little steps to put in right up here on both ends. And I'm thinking about go ahead and doing the wire to go from here to here and then here to here. So I'm trying to debate if I really want to do that, because now we're getting into more of a drover style caboose. Oh no, we'll see. Okay, I'm not gonna promise anything on that. That may change. I don't know yet. But the other video, because I lost it on my phone, I did wind up making the ladders. And if you follow what I was doing, these were actually staples that I lined up. I cut them down, lined them up, and glued them, and then have some, took these paper clips right here and straightened them to make the ladders. Now I will have to do some more like little filing in there, just to smooth and crisp everything up. So that will have to be done. I still got to drill the holes in top for these to go sit into before being trimmed for the last time, and these will be painted as well. I haven't really decided on whether or not what color, because again, I need to get to an auto parts store to see if they carry the, I guess that's like a mustard yellow or a yellow. I'll find it, but I'll know the color by sight, but I can't think of the actual color they have it listed as for the NDM. And then, of course, I will need to contact Circus City about getting decals for the NDM, so I can get that on here and get this painted up. It'll be the first kitbash car caboose on my old roster. And again, this was started out as an 027 model MPC and post Lionel. The reason why I combine these two together, this one, you can see through. I don't like that. This one was a better plastic, but it was damaged when it came in. So, sorry about that. So, I combined the two to make a long caboose. And I gave it the scale length and the scale height. But as far as width-wise, no. But with the marker lights on there, it gives the illusion that it is scale width. So if you look at it from one direction, it looks scale. If you look at it from the rear, it looks scale. Other than a few little minor details as far as sanding goes, just about done with that. I'm going to remake the handrails for here on each end, and the handrails on side. And then this will pretty much be done. Other than the smokestack, the roof walk, these will have to be painted. That'll pretty much be it, really. I'm not, like I said, I might do some minor interior detailing. You know, maybe make a couple chairs or, I don't know, round table or something. I don't know. but the inside's going to get painted as well. And then we'll just kind of wing it from there if I decide to detail the interior. If y'all missed, well, I know y'all missed the part where I showed how I was building these. The concept for the wires, as weird as it sounds, I actually did this on my little 242 tender. That little car is getting repainted, the whole locomotive, in fact. So this is what I'm doing, okay? Regular paper clip. You take it, bend it out a little bit, get yourself some needle nose. Do not go all the way down to the clippers. And just kind of start working. Start working that bend, a little at a time. Nothing major. You know, don't be trying to do a whole bunch at one time. You're just going to kind of work it until it's nice and flat. And there you go. Now, if you get to the point where you see a nice little bend, take it down before your cutters. Kind of press on it a little bit. And you can rotate this thing. You need to get it straight. There you go. Nice and straight. You can use it and rebend it. And there again, that will work, you know, very nicely. This is a very old school trick, okay? A lot of you guys that did old scale back in the 40s, late 40s to the 50s, the 60s, the 70s, would use this trick right here with paper clips. It was something that would last, and when it was painted, nobody knew. This was actually something I learned many years ago from an old man that was modeling in Oskill. So, and that was one of his old school tricks from many years ago. In fact, that man was in his 70s then. My understanding is he passed away at the age of like 85. So he lived a good life, and I understand his train collection is now with his grandson. So there we go, we have that. And I will see y'all on another video. Probably we'll shoot for tomorrow. I've got to find me a Walmart and pick up some small drill bits and maybe a handle to hand drill it. And see what they got as far as like a primer. Or even find me an automotive store that sells the Duplicolor paint. As always, please hit like and subscribe. You know, it does help the channel grow. I do not ask for support in any way. You know, I enjoy doing this for y'all. I'm really big, and this is a lot of fun for me. As always, keep the shiny side up, rubber down. I will see y'all in the next video. Please take care of yourselves. Good night.